happy to be here in Las Vegas. Believe it or not, it's my first time to visit Las Vegas. pag nagbibisita po ako ng US, which is often, lagi lang akong either nasa East Coast o nasa California.
In a recent visit to Sin City, former Philippine Vice President Leni Robredo sought more support in the U.S. for her non-government organization, Angat Buhay. In a speech at a gathering, Robredo, who hails from Camarines Sur in the Bicol region, commended her supporters.
I'm so happy to see everyone. Nagulat din ako, marami pa din naka-pink. It is such an honor to be at the receiving end of all your help. And what makes it sweeter is the fact that even if you are so far away from home, pinaglalaban niyo pa din yung ating bansa.
The Southern Nevada community gathered to show support for Angat Buhay, which focuses on education by building classrooms in remote areas of the Philippines.
Yung 30 million niya, they were able to build, gobyerno to, they were able to build 8 classrooms. Kung binigay yun sa atin, 37 classrooms ang mabibuild natin. So, but people don't realize the cost of corruption. Sa Pilipinas, dahil patronage politics ang umiiral, ang mindset ng tao, di bale ng corrupt, marami namang project.
Filipino-American philanthropist and businesswoman Lloyda Nicholas Lewis is a staunch supporter of Robredo, especially during the Philippine presidential elections in 2022. Lewis says Angat Buhay instills hope and promotes unity by mobilizing the efforts of partners, volunteers, and supporters to empower Filipino communities, particularly those marginalized.
They have failed to identify a true leader, a true servant leader that could have done so much for the Philippines, especially the very poor and the poor, which comprises 40 million of our 110 million Filipinos.
Robredo says Angat Buhay remains committed to implementing community-driven development programs centered on healthcare, disaster response, and community empowerment.
We have to build a certain kind of reputation para kami yung maging conduit. We can't just be doing relief work. We can't just be doing rehabilitation work. It has to be preventive also.
Out from public service and now a private individual, Robredo also shared updates on the organizing part of their program.
That is one way of training Filipinos to be more mindful of the issues around them.
Robredo's NGO is viewed by her supporters as a beacon of hope and collective action. Robredo is hopeful that more Filipinos near and far will support them to continue uplifting marginalized Filipino communities through empowerment.
Bev Llorente, ABS-CBN
News, Las Vegas, Nevada.